figuring out, getting them all at the same level because they hadn't had a teacher. So we're gonna show you what we did. I know a lot of you have heard this lovely recorder playing. So what we do is we have a system that we use as we learn where they can earn belts. It's called recorder karate. And the first song that they learn without music or anything that we do is Hot Cross Buns. I'm sure a lot of you heard it a lot. Well, you're gonna hear it tonight, which is a little bit different. We had to add some more instruments in and make it fun. But this is the first song that they all learned back in September when we started.
Thank you.
this year that music should be a huge part of is creativity. Having them learn what it is to create music, not just have somebody throwing it at them all the time. So we also, with the ORF approach, really try and use literature in the classroom to help the students get across curricular understanding how they're all related. So we've been working on learning about the different instruments of the orchestra. So I read them a book called The Remarkable Farpoint Bride, and it's about a young boy who does instruments. And what we did is I'm going to read you in sections kind of a little poem about the story. But in between, they are going to be playing four measures that they wrote themselves. Then they got to pick what instruments they were going to play them on. So it's a little bit scary. It's new for them, like they hadn't done this before. I threw it at them and said, this is what we're gonna do this year. They're a little bit leery, but they're getting there. What you'll hear is you'll hear them saying things that go with the book to help them learn the rhythm. So they'll be saying things like flute, altogether, trombone, triangle, violin, and that helps them to get the rhythm. So we are going to present to you The Remarkable Farpoint Bride. Do you guys all have your music? Was an incredible musical genius. Whether string, woodwind, brass, or percussion, every instrument he tried, he left his musical passions unsatisfied. Group one, ready, play. At the age of three, he mastered violin, but his happiness didn't last. He smashed it on the living room floor, and playing the strings was no more. Group two, ready, play. At the age of five, he conquered the flute, and Farkle's spirit soared. But at six, the flute was flung in the lake. The sound of the woodwind he would no longer make. Group three, ready, play. At the age of seven, he bested trombone, but soon his joy turned to despair. Farkle told his parents to throw it away, and brass no more would he play. Group four, ready, play. At the age of nine, Farkle learned xylophone, cymbals, and drums. Before very long, the crash and the boom brought Farkle gloom, and he left the percussion room. Group five, ready, play. At the age of 10, purely by mistake, Farkle discovered conducting. He took the baton and gave the downbeat and found his favorite sound. All the instruments playing together sounded so sweet and brought the crowd to its feet. Group six, ready, play. As he conducts brass, percussion, woodwinds, and strings. Now beating with pride, he is maestro, Remarkable Farpoint Bride. Instruments. guys all ready? Group one, are you ready? Group one, where are you? Ready? Here we go. Group one, ready, play.
Thank you.
three-quarter eight GE, because those are the notes that are in. Here we go, room one. Are you ready? Group two, ready, play. Group three, here we go. Group three, ready, play. Group four, here we go. Group four, ready, play. fourth grade group. This is Cook and Mrs. Jones' class. They are going to, the rest of our recorded journey this year was the Orange Belt, which was Merrily We Roll Along, which will sound strangely familiar. You might know it as Mary Had a Little Lamb.
Thank you.
Nice. Group three, here we go. Group three, ready, play. All right, nice job. Group four, here we go. Group four, ready, play. Several years since there were concerts here in Central. because of the pandemic and then the lack of a music teacher. And so we started out this school year with our fifth graders. I was here for about 3 weeks last year, at the end of the year. So this year we started out and we were working on, some of the kids played recorder in third grade and fourth grade. Great. Some of the kids played recorder in third grade, but not fourth grade. Some of the kids never played recorder at all. So we had to find a way to get everybody to the same level, because some of these kids went without a music teacher for all of last year. They had substitutes, they really didn't do music. So we were working on trying to get everybody at the same level, get them caught up. They have been working really hard. And some of them had to go back to the beginning, which is never fun. But we went back to the beginning. We use a program called Recorder Karate. And when they play a song, they have to play it for me. That's how I know. Are they getting the concept? Are they understanding? When they play it for me, they can do it in person or they can do it online and a video. And once they play it for me, they get a colored band to go around the bottom of their recorder. So tonight, we're going to kind of show you the progression of the first three songs. There are 9 belts altogether. Some of the students have earned all the way on their own, all the way to the 9th belt, which is their black belt. Quite a few of them up here, see. Everybody up here should have all the way through orange. How many people have green? How many people have purple? How many people have red? How many people have blue? Does anybody up here have brown? Okay, so everybody up here, we've got some students that only need 2 more belts. And that's kind of what we're going to work on by the end of the year. So we are going to show you the first song that they learn is Hot Cross Buns. And I'm sure some of you are like, please, I've heard this too many times at home. But what we did is I'm going to show you the first 3 notes that we learned, B, A, and G, Hot Cross Buns. But we had to make it a little more exciting, so we added some 4 instruments to it. So we are going to show you our version of Hot Cross Buns.
Thank you.
The ORF approach, which is what all these instruments are you see up here, it's a method of teaching music. And one of the things about the ORF method is that it's supposed to be about creativity. The teacher's stepping back and letting the kids go, and sometimes it is so hard. Because when we're in class and I say, okay, go do this, exactly what you saw is what happens. And it's really hard not to want to step in and start telling them what they should do. So what we did was, we actually have a literature component too, to ORF. This class has been learning a lot about instruments, the instruments of the orchestra, because they have a big decision to make this year about whether or not they play in band. I highly encourage it, just letting you all know. Not only do I highly encourage it as a teacher, but I am a parent of a son who's about to graduate from college. I will tell you, for those of you that are like, well, my kid does sports, mine does too. He's a college football player, and he has a music minor. He's a biology major. He's going to medical school. 83% of medical school acceptants have some sort of music in their background, playing an instrument. I highly encourage it. You can do both. In fact, tomorrow, after school, I'm jetting over to Kalamazoo for my son's final performance as a college student. So I highly encourage them, check it out. I always tell the kids, you can do it for a year. If you don't like it, say, it's not for me. But if you don't do it, you can't really go back. It's not too easy. Also, sometimes we hear, well, but it's expensive. If your child wants to do it, money is not an issue. We will help you figure it out, and it all remains confidential. So we've been working on learning what the instruments are so that they can make a choice. And one of the books that we read is a book called The Remarkable Farkle McBride. And so what we did, and for time's sake, I'm gonna not do exactly what we did in class, but I retold the story to them, and in between the telling of the story, they wrote four measures of music. And so it looks kind of like this when we put it together. And we use literature and language to help with the acquisition of being able to do this. So when they wrote their rhythms, they had words that went with it. Words like flute, violin, trombone, triangle, all together, flute. And that helps with the language. So some of them, if they do it right, will be saying words while they play their rhythm for you. So I'm gonna have each group play their four measures that they learned in class. They wrote this, they decided what instruments to play. It's a brand new thing this year that I made them do. Some of them didn't like it so much at first, but this is a brand new thing, so we're gonna present it to you. All right, group one, group one, ready, play. Group two, here we go. Group two, ready, play. Group three, here we go. Group three, ready, play. Thank you. Ready, play. All right, nice job, group two. Here we go, where's group two? Okay, group two, ready, play.
Thank you.
coming in with them. So, class, for time's sake, I'm not going to read the whole story. They already know how what happens, okay? And so, what we're going to do is I'm just going to go group by group. You guys ready? Okay. So, are you guys in one? All right. They made it easier on me to stay in one spot. Here we go. Group one, ready, play.
Thank you.
group one? Where's my group two? Where's group three? And group four? Five and six. All right. There we go. Are you ready? Group one, ready, play. Nicely done. All right, do not know, they're twins. All right, room 5, are you ready? Here we go, 1, 2, ready, play. Ready, play.